teachers got creative this year and incorporated Halloween into their curriculum. Let's take a look at what this week had in store.
I'm Gavin Moore, and I'm here with Mr. Foote.
Morning, Gavin.
Good morning. So, with Halloween around the corner, I was wondering, do you have any like special activities you're doing with your students based around the holiday?
Yeah, my graphic design classes are making some Halloween posters, unleashing their creativity a little bit with Photoshop, taking some of their favorite scary movies or just Halloween movies in general, and posting all kinds of faces on different people. So, pretty awesome turnout, a lot of creativity.
All right, that's all. Thank you for your time.
I'm Brad Forsman here with Ms. Clow. Ms. Clow, since it's getting close to Halloween, what kind of projects do you guys do in the class?
Well, Spanish-speaking countries don't really celebrate Halloween, but they have their own celebration, Day of the Dead. So all week, we kind of prep for the week with doing lots of crafts with skeletons and skulls and pinatas and sugar skulls and all that stuff there. So we'll put those on display once they're all set and ready.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm Gavin Moore, and I'm here with Ms. Eichner. So Ms. Eichner, with Halloween being today, is there any like special Halloween activities you guys are doing?
So usually around Halloween time with my 11th graders, I really like to try to read Macbeth by William Shakespeare. It's actually one of my favorites that he wrote. And so what I actually have them do is I have them decorate witches' hats, and then we put them on my door. And they put little pieces of information that they learned from like our pre-reading notes ahead of time. And then I keep it up pretty much the whole month until the end. But I really like that because I think it definitely sets the mood for Halloween.
Alright, thank you for your time.
Yeah, no problem.
I'm Hunter, I'm here with Ms. Samsel. So Ms. Samsel, what Halloween activities are you doing in the classroom?
This year I wanted to try something new. I was actually watching Nightmare Before Christmas with my daughters this summer. Thank you, Disney Plus. And I saw the Oogie Boogie song, and in that scene there was a lot of black light characters and skeletons and things like that. And I thought, why not do it during the Day of the Dead around that holiday, which is Calavera season. So this is what we created in the art room using blacklight reactive paint. So I'm super excited. We're going to be getting a blacklight display. So really
thank
cool.
you.
Welcome.
I'm Gavin Warren. I'm here with Mr. Newcomer. So Mr. Newcomer, with Halloween, is there any special activities or assignments that you're doing in your classroom?
Yeah, so for the 7th grade geography class, I let them pick a country, and they're able to research what those countries do for Halloween. And so they're finding a lot of like similarities, but a lot of really cool differences to see what everybody does around the world.
All right, thank you for your time.
Well, I'm Josh, I'm here with Ms. Hayden. Are you doing anything Halloween related this month?
Oh, well, if you've had me in class, you know that I love Halloween. So the entire month of October, we did a whole horror and fantasy genre unit. So we read Telltale Heart, and we did some analysis, and we did some pictures with hearts and eyeballs, of course. And then we did Monkey's Paw, and we did Creepy Monkey's Paw hand graphic organizers. We did the Raven, and we did Creepy Raven cutouts. And of course, Mrs. Becker and Mrs. Schoonmaker and myself were all dressed up today for Hocus Pocus. So we did analysis there, but yes, in short, we did a lot of scary stuff.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm Gavin Warren. I'm here with Ms. Becker. So, Ms. Becker, is there any Halloween activities you're doing in your classrooms?
Absolutely. I'm a total math nerd, so obviously we're doing math. But I found these fun Halloween problems that involve pictures, and you have to find the value of the pictures. It can be solved using algebra, or it can just be solved with guess and check. So everybody gets to solve puzzles thinking they're having fun, but they're really doing deep math.
Okay. Sounds good. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
I'm Hunter, and I'm here with Mr. Morocco. So, Mr. Morocco, are you doing any Halloween activities for your classrooms?
So, my freshmen, third and eighth periods this year, we just are covering the Salem witchcraft trials. Specifically, we're doing all of New England, but this week we are holding our witchcraft trial for both classes. Specifically, we are looking into the lives of five individual women that were alive in 1692, so we are hosting two trials at that time.
Thank you.
You're welcome.